Well, hey there. Today, this video blog is for Tuesday, February 8th, and we're still in the book of Romans. Today, as you are watching this, we're going to do verse 9 all the way to the end of verse 20. So we got a little bit to cover, but it shouldn't take too long. I want to highlight just a few truths out of it. Basically, the premise of these 11 verses is simply to say, 12 verses, is simply to say, all people are sinners. New Living Translation. You ready? Let's go. Verse 9 says, well then, should we conclude that the Jews are better than others? And Paul says very, very clearly, no. Not at all. Are the Jews better than other people? Are they less sinful? Are they more qualified to receive salvation? Is there anything special about being a Jew? And Paul says clearly, no. There's nothing special about being a Jew. Not at all, he says. For we have already shown that all people, whether Jews or Gentiles, are under the power of sin. So there's nothing that qualifies now Jewish people under the new covenant of Jesus Christ, as he died for the sins of the world. There's nothing that qualifies Jewish people to receive anything more than Gentiles. There's nothing that, there's no color barrier, there's no racial barrier, there's no gender barrier. There's another verse in, I believe it's in Galatians, that says, no, we are all one, whether male or female, whether barbarian or this ethnic group or that ethnic group or whatever, we are all one in Jesus Christ. There is nobody that God looks down and favors more because of any sort of biasness. I mean, we receive God's favor because of our faith and because of our walk and because of our choices. Of course, there's some people that have received more favor, but God isn't biased. He doesn't love Israel or love Canada or love Australia more than he loves anything else. There's certain prophetic scriptures and certain prophecies in the Bible that God says these are going to come to pass, but he has no more love for a Jewish person than he does for you. If you're not Jewish, he has no more love for a black person than he does a white. He has no more love for a white person than he does a Chinese person or any group. So just to make that pretty clear, the Bible says we are all under the power of sin. As the scriptures say, and it quotes from the Old Testament here, it says, no one is righteous, not even one. Not even one person is right. Nobody who's ever lived, no man who has ever lived has been righteous in and of himself. It says, no one is truly wise in verse 11. No one is seeking God. Verse 12, all have turned away. All have become useless. No one does good, not a single one. So if you're suffering with condemnation, or if you think that, you know, you're just a dirty, rotten sinner, and no, man, you need Jesus Christ and the power of his grace just like everybody else. Not that you're going to stay in that junk. You know, you can crawl your way out of it. By the power of the Spirit of God, you can be transformed into the image and likeness of Jesus Christ simply by making a decision to invite him to be the Lord and Master and Savior of your life. I'm getting ahead of myself here. Verse 13, their talk is foul, like a stench from an open grave. Well, that's pretty nasty. Their tongues are filled with lies. Snake venom drips from their lips. Verse 14, their mouths are full of cursing and bitterness. Their mouths are full of cursing and bitterness. Verse 15, they run to commit murder. Verse 16, destruction and misery always follow them. 17, they don't know where to find peace. They don't know where to find peace. Verse 18, they have no fear of God at all. All quoting, Paul quotes a bunch of Old Testament scriptures here. And then verse 19, he brings his thoughts to a conclusion. He says, obviously, the law, which is the law, the Mosaic law, the law that was given to the Jewish people, but now God is using this law to turn the whole world to Jesus Christ, the Savior. It says, the law applies to those whom it was given, for its purpose is to keep people from having excuses. Because everybody is going to heaven, aren't they? We want to think so, but it's not the case. The Bible says very clearly, the wages of sin is death. And that death is separation from God. That death, Jesus says it very clearly. And if you read through the Gospels, you'll see a literal hell. You'll see a place of eternal separation from God. I've never been there, but I know that it exists through Scripture and just through the witness of the Holy Spirit. This is a real place where people go, and if we do not receive the gift of God, the life of God, then that is our decision to go there, to be separated from God. He doesn't want us to go. He loves us with an everlasting love, and He's giving the world a chance. He's giving you a chance. He's given me, and I've said yes to Him. He saved my life, you know. We could talk about that more, but it says the law is just to keep people from having excuses, because everybody is, not everybody, some people are righteous in their own eyes. And the Bible says in the book of Proverbs, I believe, and also in Isaiah, you know, do not be wise in your own eyes. Woe to those who are wise in their own opinion or wise in their own eyes. God says, you know, he's the one who judges sin. He's the one who says what's right and what's wrong, and He's given us the law to do that. So the law isn't bad. The law just shows us where we're at. And so it was given to keep people from having excuses and to show that the entire world is guilty before God. In the last verse we're going to do today, for no one can be made right with God by doing what the law commands. Let's sum it up. The law simply shows us how sinful we are. The law simply shows us how sinful we are. So Paul paints a very bleak picture, but it's a reality construed picture that Paul gives us, that Paul paints, and he says, this is where you're at. And this is what proves it. There's no doubting it. You're a sinner. We'll talk about the next few verses tomorrow when Paul brings Jesus Christ onto the scene. And that's a very good thing. This is what the hope of the gospel of the kingdom of God that we proclaim to all men, that we're talking about, that we're shouting out through every medium in the will of God that we possibly can, that we feel will bring benefits. And so God bless you, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Have an amazing day.